So you have just bought a house, or you're walking through a house and you want to make it open concept. But can you actually take those walls out? Are they load bearing or non load bearing? How do you even know? By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to tell if a wall is load bearing or non load bearing. I'm Dan Nodge, founder of Emmett Leo Homes, a luxury home building company and your insider into the world of building and redesigning luxury homes. Quick reminder to subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell right down below so that you can get all the new videos as soon as they come out. Okay, so here we are on site at another luxury flip that we're doing. One of the things that a lot of people do is tearing out walls. So you get in there and you say, you know what, let's just tear out all these walls. But how do you really know if that wall can be taken out? And if you need to take it out, what do you have to do? So we're gonna take a walk through and we'll see exactly how structure comes from the bottom up. And I'll explain all the concepts behind walls, load-bearing walls, and taking them out. Let's go. You gotta know the difference between what actually a load-bearing wall and a non-load-bearing wall is.
A load-bearing wall is a wall that supports the weight of a floor or roof above. They support the weight of floor joists or roof trusses that are typically running in the opposite direction above. These are the walls that are holding the house up, and if you take them out, you have to find a way to support the weight that they are holding with something else, often a beam. A non-load-bearing wall is a wall that separates rooms without supporting any of the load or weight of the roof or floor above it. If you take these walls out, the house will not be affected. Most walls that run parallel to the floor joists above are rarely bearing weight. The tough part is differentiating between walls that run at a 90 degree angle to the floor joists, because some may be bearing and others may not.
I'll give you three quick ways to figure out whether your wall is load bearing or not. After that, we'll dive into a little deeper stuff about foundations and why this stuff actually matters. Okay, so one of the easiest ways to figure out if a wall is load bearing or non load bearing is to look up at the ceiling above and see which way the joist runs. So when we look up a bit, we can see this wall has joists running perpendicular. That means that it's coming in at 90 degrees. If they're running parallel, that means that the wall is definitely non-load bearing. Now, you might not be able to see, you might have drywall up, you might have a ceiling up, you may have something impeding your ability to see the joists above you. If that's the case, we can really look at the structure or the dimensions of the house. Like in this one, we are shorter this way than we are this way. Typically, that means that our joists are gonna run the shortest span. Now, the third way to tell whether a wall is load-bearing or non-load-bearing is to go outside and look at your roof. Now, if we have a gable roof, which means that you have a peak and your wall goes all the way up, that means your joists run perpendicular to that. So on a gable roof, we know now which way the roof trusses go, and typically the structural beam will run perpendicular to that. Now we have to understand a little more about the structure of a house and the foundation and actually what supports it. So homes are typically built on piles or footings. Most of the time we have large spans in the basement, which means we're gonna have beams in the middle. Under those beams, we'll see posts. That's a great indication and a starting point for us if we need to dive deeper, because those quick ways to analyze aren't working. So we have to start in the basement. So let's go. Okay, so here we are in the basement. Right now you can see we have a ripped apart basement, so it's quite easy for us. You can see the span of the room. Now, the room is wider this way than it is this way, so we kind of look right in the middle, and we can see that our main beam, our structural beam for the house, is right above us here. Now, another easy way to tell that is we have posts. We actually have three posts. Now, you might see posts like this. You can't see them, but they're covered up by drywall. So chances are this is a post if you have one like this in your basement, and you don't really have to guess anymore what it is. You may also have open posts if your basement isn't finished. These teleposts sit underneath and support the structure. Underneath here, you'll find that there is a footing that's supporting the weight of that structure that's holding it up. So you can't just put teleposts anywhere. You need to actually pour a foundational support underneath these teleposts. The third telepost is actually hidden inside that wall. So that might actually happen in your house where you're looking for the teleposts and you can't find them. Typically, a good home builder will hide those posts either next to stairs or in walls so that they don't stick out like a sore thumb. So we found our beam and we're looking right at it here. We can see the joist right above here. So maybe you might have to cut open to see, but here it is. So we know which way our joists run. Now we're gonna measure how far we are from one wall or the other so that when we go upstairs, we can figure out where the beam is right underneath us. So I'm gonna measure from the outside of this beam all the way to my exterior wall so that when we go upstairs, we can take the exterior wall upstairs, measure back, and we'll know the exact position of our beam. Okay, so we've come back upstairs and we look at our exterior wall. This is the one that we measured from. We're gonna take that measurement from the basement and stretch it all the way back over here and we'll find that the beam is directly below this wall. That means that this wall is structural or load bearing. We might be confused because this wall runs the same way and the joists run this way. Perpendicular to it. See, that you might think that that would be structural, but it's not. Okay, so let's say that you got a little ahead of yourself and you ripped the drywall off of a wall that you wanted to rip out. Somebody said, hey, is that structural or not? Your drywall above, the easiest way for you to figure out which way the joists are running is to rip that drywall off. If you don't want to cut a hole, you can use a stud finder. If you don't want to use a stud finder, you may actually be able to just press on the drywall and see if you can get any of the screws to pop out. That'll show you kind of where the joists run. A third way to find out is actually to go down to the city archive. Now, every city's different, every town is different. I don't actually know where your plans for your house are. Starting about a century ago, we started registering house plans with cities. Your plans may actually be in the city archive that you can get a copy of, or maybe you called a builder and it was a tract home and they can provide a plan for you. On those plans, it'll say exactly which way the joists run. And now I'm gonna show you exactly what it looks like when you take out a structural wall and what you have to replace it with. Follow me. Okay, so we have this nice open concept dining room now. When we first bought the house, there was a wall all the way across here. That beam that you saw downstairs is actually underneath my feet. We wanted to take this wall out. What we had to do was we needed an engineer to design us a beam that would hold the weight of that structural wall. So this beam is actually holding up everything above it. And this is two stories and a roof system above, so it had to be pretty big, and it spans about 20 feet. So that's why we have this 4-ply LVL beam. Now, one thing you'll notice, when you do take out the wall and you put the beam up, there's two points that actually hold the load. One is on that side, and one is on this side. These beams are gonna hold the entire weight of that load. That's why we load them up, hammer them together, and create this super strong post that's underneath the beam. So you can see we have this beautiful open concept dining room behind us now, and now you know how to figure out if a wall is load bearing or not load bearing so that you can take out a wall and also have that open concept house that you always wanted. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like, comment, or share it with someone that you know needs it. For more information, go to my website at emmettleohomes.com, where you can find pictures of our luxury projects, as well as download our luxury home planning guide. Thanks for watching.